strength and powerful love of nurturing, encouragement, and protection that you have provided to these students throughout their time at Hampton and throughout their lives. And so, graduates, on the count of three, I'm going to ask you to help me say Happy Mother's Day. One, two, three. Wes Coleman and his lovely wife Barbara, and to all of our trustees who are being supported. Mayor Donnie Tuck, City of Hampton, the city who our name bears, thank you for your support. To Mayor Philip Jones, City of Newport News, thank you. Other elected officials and business and community leaders across the Hampton Roads community, thank you. And in addition to this being the 154th commencement, this is also the 108th Alumni Reunion Weekend. And so all of our alumni, please give yourself a round of applause. Thank you for being here. I offer a special shout out of thanks to the Golden Class of 1974, the Golden Class, and to all of our emeritus leaders in the audience today. Next, I wish to acknowledge who has served our university for 38 years. Thank you, Dr. Kagan. Finally, I wish to personally thank Reverend Dr. Howard John Wesley for being our guest speaker today. He is the pastor of my home church in Alexandria, Virginia. He is a courageous and dynamic visionary leader. Again, congratulations, graduates. Thank God. And go Pirates. Love you, Joshua. Have a great day.
Good morning once again, everyone. Please bow with me for this morning's opening prayer. Our Father and our God, how excellent and praised in the name of all that is holy and righteous and good. Amen and amen.
Sons of the ocean, product of the river's potion. He who keeps hoping, he who keeps his own motion, who proposes his future because he knows he is chosen, who knows what hand to play because it's well beyond noted that we avoided all possibilities of folding. Filled with emotion to be open to the notion of distilled devotion towards the token of one's word or the integrity of the unspoken. This is what was made for us. It's prophetically wrote in the land while we're holding on to another brother's hand and we walk through our moment. We will be the Hampton Man. One day, I decree, eventually. But we might have been too free to understand when we first came here, merely not mere men, but boys by the sea. Thank you.
Senior Distinguished Teacher Award recipient. Following the presentation of the awardees,
graduating class of 2024 of Hampton University. Looks like you made it. You all know across the nation, today is graduation at several universities and colleges, including that other wannabe HU in DC. And even though 153 classes have sat for you since today prior to you being here, this class of 2024, you are able to quote the words of that poet, Kendrick Lamar, in his most recent rap battle defeat of Aubrey Drake Graham. And only this class can say those four words, they not lie us. You all are unique. You have navigated the waters. He is a threat to Esther's people. Haman represents a threat to all that the Lord is doing in people like Esther and Mordecai. Haman wants to destroy affirmative action and make certain that no government funding is supportive of diversity, equity, and inclusion. Haman wants to rewrite the history of the people and remove slavery because it makes him feel bad. Haman denies the privilege and entitlement that he has received after 400 years of free slave labor. And in his ignorance, Haman says things like, slavery benefited your people. Haman believes that systemic racism is dead because he's never called anybody out of their name. Haman believes that Black Lives Matters are rioters, but insurrectionists are patriots. Haman believes that God is American, that the angels sing the Star Spangled Banner, and the Constitution belongs in the Holy Bible. Haman thinks that he ought to remain in office and should never be prosecuted or persecuted for anything that he does because he bears the title that goes alongside. And Hamptonians, pirates, the problem is not with Haman, the problem is with Esther. Because Esther is now in the palace and she's not aware of what's going on with her people. She's allowed her degree to detach her from what's going on with her people. She's allowed the door that her degree opened to put her in a place of prosperity where she is now blinded to the pains of the folk that she represents. She has detached herself because doors have opened. Y'all, I'm not from your generation. I come from the 90s, and there's some 90s babies in here who will tell you that the defining movie of our generation came out in 1991. It starred Cuba Gooding Jr., Morris Chestnut, Angela Bassett, O'Shea Jackson, better known as Ice Cube. It was called Boys in the Hood. And at the end of Boys in the Hood, after all the violence in South Central, after Ricky had been shot down, Doughboy was sitting there with Trey and listening to what he says. Either they don't know, they don't show, or they don't care what's going on in the hood. Hamptonians, I came by to tell you, it's a shame not to know. It's even worse not to care. And I came by to ask you the same question Mordecai asked Esther. Do you care? Do you care that Jalen Smith, a Black graduate student in journalism, while protesting the war in the Middle East, was mocked with gestures of monkey and ape on the campus of Ole Miss University? Or is all you want to do take your degree and go get you a job? Do you care?
for the Graduate College. Please stand. we will maintain a dignified ceremony.
We, the 2024 graduates of Hampton University, are conscious of our obligation to be both faithful followers and dependable leaders. With all other alumni of Hampton University, we commit ourselves to be worthy sons and daughters of our alma mater, to realize in ourselves the high standards of her tradition of unselfish service to mankind. To contribute liberally of our